I'm impressed, Agent Archer. I expected that promoting you to field operations would be disastrous, but I never imagined a catastrophe of these proportions. You've now managed to botch two high-profile, high-stakes missions. Care to explain?
If you can master your animosity enough to address me in a civil tone, I'll attempt to explain, in terms you might understand, exactly how I believe we've arrived at this impasse, sir.
Your inadequacy is matched only by your impertinence. If you find my manners offensive, I suggest you find a line of work more suited to your delicate nature. Gardening, for example, or perhaps motherhood.
This is getting us nowhere.
Neither is she. I plan to submit a formal request to review her record for dismissal.
You'll do nothing of the sort. Even if we had the luxury of discharging one of our last remaining operatives, which we don't, there are proper channels to consider. No agent of Unity has ever been relieved of duties without a formal, thorough inquest. Personally, while I admit that I'm concerned about the results we've seen thus far, I'm not convinced that Agent Archer is entirely to blame. Until I am convinced, we'll continue with our current plan of action.
Thank you, sir.
Don't thank me yet. It's quite probable that things will get worse before they get better.
I don't see how that's possible.
Did you get a look at your assailant?
Aye, that I did.
Did you recognize him?
Sergeant Magnus Armstrong, born in Glasgow, Scotland, 1925. Frequently in trouble as a lad due to a penchant for fighting. By all accounts, he was a good-natured, likable young man. Never bullied anybody, only picked fights with boys that were game for a brawl. Got kicked out of several schools before his parents finally stuck him in a military academy. During the war, he served as a sapper in France and Germany, everything from mine removal to demolitions and sabotage. Earned himself quite a reputation for his reckless antics. The most popular legend had to do with a bridge he allegedly crippled with nothing but a shovel and a hand grenade. A German supply train did the rest. When it reached the weakened section of the bridge, the whole structure came crashing down.
It's a shame this chap ended up on the wrong side of the law.
To the best of our knowledge, he's never been involved in anything this big before. Most of his arrests since returning from the war have been related to public brawling.
Any theories on why he didn't simply shoot you when he had the chance?
I'll be sure to ask him when I bring him in.
That's assuming you get the opportunity.
She just might. We may have a lead. This morning, West German custom officials in Hamburg discovered several suspicious-looking chemical containers aboard a Finnish cargo freighter. Fortunately, these chaps decided to inform us rather than seizing the contraband outright, which gives us a chance to conduct a covert investigation.
You believe this is the link to Dr. Schenker?
It could well be. If so, given the specific chemicals found aboard the freighter, it's a fairly safe bet the kidnappers are not only aware of Dr. Schenker's research, but also determined to capitalize upon it.
If our theories are correct, the kidnappers are in Hamburg or will be arriving shortly. A good spy could find them. Fortunately, we're sending a good spy on this mission. You'll be working with him.
A new partner?
More like a supervisor.
An American named Thomas Goodman. Perhaps you've heard of him.
Aye, but I thought he was killed in Amsterdam.
Nearly. He's a resourceful chap, though. Made a daring escape on a stolen bicycle with half the Dutch police force in hot pursuit and KGB agents waiting in ambush around every corner. Smashing story. I'm sure he'll recount it if you ask him. At any rate, you're to rendezvous with him in Germany and see what the two of you can dig up. You'll take your orders directly from him during this mission.
Thank God.
Very good, sir. Thank you.
Agent Archer?
Yes, sir.
What was it like falling out of that plane?
I promise to tell you about it sometime.
I tell you she's a liability.
Perhaps, but I'm not convinced yet.
What will it take to convince you? How many more catastrophes must we suffer through? Because keeping her on the active list will lead to further disasters. Of that, I'm certain.
Yes, I can see that you are.
Our purpose is to preserve freedom, to protect innocent lives, to combat evil, wherever it manifests. We can't afford to tolerate anything that stands in the way of that goal. The girl may be spirited, but she's virtually incompetent.
I admire your sense of duty, but I question your judgment. I can't say that at my prime I would have performed any better than she under the circumstances.
You're assuming her reports are entirely genuine. Personally, I wouldn't be at all surprised to learn that she'd colored the facts. The bloody things read like adventure novels.
So now you're indicting her credibility?
Does that seem unreasonable? The girl was a thief, for goodness sakes. A little skepticism seems prudent.
I'll take it under advisement.
Look, it's not too late to pull her off the assignment. I've read the American's file. He's perfectly capable of handling an operation like this on his own.
Probably so. But I have the strangest feeling a woman's touch is exactly what we need on this one.
I can't argue with you when you're like this.
No, you can't.
I hope you realize you're letting yourself be ruled by intuition. Reason tends to make a far more reliable counselor.
You might ruminate on that adage yourself.
Huh.
Welcome to Advanced Field Tactics. Here's a perfume that'll really knock 'em out. Literally. It sprays a cloud of vapor that contains a potent sedative capable of knocking out a horse, let alone an adult human. Just be careful not to wander into the cloud yourself, or who knows where or even if you'll wake up. Why don't you try it out on Leon here? He's been up for 32 hours straight working on a new prototype. The rest might do him some good.
Proceed to Hamburg, West Germany.
How am I going to get in there?
I demand to be let in.
I'm sorry. That's impossible.
But my girlfriend is inside.
I understand that, but I can't let you in.
Can I at least go find her?
Sadly, no.
Why not?
Because the club is full. Nobody else is allowed.
Well, can you go find her for me?
I must stay here.
Then can you send someone to find her?
Everyone is busy. You will just have to wait.
I want to speak to someone in charge.
As I said, everyone is busy. If you come back tomorrow after 10 a.m., perhaps you can speak with someone then.
But my girlfriend is in there now.
Perhaps you should have come together. Then you would not be in this situation, and I would not have to listen to you shouting at me.
I'm just getting warmed up.
It's not my fault that you're out here and she is in there. It is your fault. She is your girlfriend. You should have known better than to ask her to wait for you inside a club that is known to fill up every single night.
Can I please just go and find her?
I said no, and I meant it. Now go away or I will call the police.
Schweinhund.
Scheißkopf.
Is it always as crowded?
Yeah, the place fills up every night. People come for the music.
Do you think they'll let us in?
I doubt it.
I have to get in there.
Really? Well, let me help you. I'll distract the bouncer so you can climb in through that window. Watch out for the camera, though.
Thanks.
My pleasure. Have fun.
Hello, big boy.
Well, hello there.
It sure is crowded tonight.
It usually is. This place is very popular.
You must meet a lot of pretty girls.
Yes, but rarely do I meet enchanting ones.
You're teasing.
I do not tease.
Promises, promises.
I get up.
will excuse me. This is all I have time for this evening. Thank you, thank you. Perhaps I will sing for you later. What is so important you need to interrupt me in the middle of a performance? You know how these people treasure my concerts. Now they will lament.
Das tut mir leid, Fräulein Wagner.
Of course, if they are sad, they will buy more drinks to drown their sorrows, which is good for business. But it troubles me to know that someone is unhappy because I was unable to give enough of myself. A gift like mine comes with terrible responsibility, you know.
Yeah, and you have so much of yourself to give.
Even such pathetic, horrible creatures as these smelly beatniks deserve some sympathy, yeah? Now then, perhaps you will care to remind me why I am talking instead of singing.
Fräulein Wagner, the super spy is here. What should we do?
So, the fly has rung the doorbell of the spider. You did the right thing. Let her have a few drinks. Then she goes to the water closet. Grab her and bring her to me. Am I understood?
Jawohl.
Good. Watch her closely. She is not to leave under any circumstances.
It will be done as you have asked.
If you succeed, perhaps I will be convinced to sing for you. Would you like that?
Very much so, Fräulein Wagner. It would be a great honor.
Then make me happy. When I am happy, I sing like a nightingale in springtime.
I love your outfit.
I do too. Can I talk you out of it?
These cramps are killing me. I wonder where my boyfriend is. He asked me to meet him here. Perhaps it's just me, but I thought the music was terrible.
How can you say that? It's unconventional, certainly, but that's what makes
this club is super groovy. Don't you think so?
How passé. Anyone can sing a melody, but it takes a true...
Would you care for a light?
Thanks, but I don't smoke.
You're holding a cigarette.
Am I? Well, what do you know? I guess old habits die hard. Say, can I borrow a dime? I want to call my mom and tell her I just met the girl of my dreams.
I gave my last dime to a worthwhile charity.
Ouch. I wasn't expecting a woman.
You weren't briefed.
They just said meet Agent Archer at 8 p.m.
Well, I'm Agent Archer.
So I gathered.
Didn't the code phrase tip you off?
I thought it was a little unusual, but I figured, hey, it's Europe. Things are different over here.
Scotch and soda. Will you have a drink?
Old Granddad, bring the bottle, a tumbler, and a bowl of ice.
Goodness, are you celebrating?
Compensating, actually.
How sad for you.
So tell me, Ms. Archer.
Oh, now don't start with that.
What?
There's no need to patronize me.
Was I patronizing you?
Yes, you were.
Well, I'm sorry, but I didn't realize I was going to have to babysit on this assignment.
I may be a woman, but that doesn't mean I can't take care of myself.
Oh, I get it. You're one of those women's libbers. Dress up in men's clothing, ride motorcycles, smoke cigars, that kind of thing.
Just because I can take care of myself doesn't mean I'm not a woman. They're not mutually exclusive, you know.
But isn't the point of women's liberation to allow young ladies like yourself to become men?
The point is to allow young ladies to become whatever they please.
Ouch. Well, if you're as deadly with a pistol as you are with your tongue, you can watch both our backs.
All right, I will. So what's the plan?
Well, the first thing is to find out who the goon is.
Excuse me?
You're being watched. If you can lure him someplace quiet, I'll jump him and find out what he's after.
That's very noble of you, but I think I can handle that little fella.
Suit yourself.
Where should I ambush him?
Try the ladies' room.
What? You think he'll follow me into the loo?
Heck yeah, look at him. He's concentrating so hard on not being noticed, he'd probably follow you into heavy traffic without a second thought. Anyway, you'll certainly be justified interrogating him, won't you?
I'd be justified in doing worse than that.
Just make sure you question him first. I'll be waiting by the stage.
Be wary of the operetta. It's a bit enthusiastic.
I can take it.
Ow! Looking for someone?
Boxner!
What now? About time things livened up.
Please, don't shoot!
She calls!
Thanks, miss. I owe you my life.
Just keep your head down till this is over.
What's going on?
Where are you?
Kill her!
Das rude!
Did you find out anything?
I was ambushed before I could question the bastard.
You okay?
I suppose, although I think someone might have tried to drug me. Something stung the back of my neck as I was heading for the ladies' room. Might have been a dart.
How do you feel now?
Not bad.
Meet me at this address in 1 hour.
Why not go together?
I want to poke around and see who these people are. They may be linked to harm.
Are you sure it's safe?
Hell no, it's reckless and dumb, but that's not going to stop me.
Well, good luck then. What should I do if you don't make it?
Don't worry, doll, I'll make it.
If you say so.
Head backstage, a friend of mine's waiting in the alley. He'll get you out of here. Just tell him you're with me.
You think he'll believe me?
He will if you tell him my code name.
I don't know your code name.
Bold Eagle.
Good God.
What's so funny?
Nothing. See you later, Bold Eagle.
Not if I see you first.
Okay. I guess I'll have to improvise.
What's in all those kegs anyway?
Beer. We supply Harm's entire staff with the finest...
Alarm!
Thank you.
We will meet again, Dark. And I will crush you!
There is a Unity safe...
What was the name of that nightclub again?
Das Einsame Valkyrie.
Ah, yes, here it is. The proprietor's name is Wagner, Inga Wagner. Ring any bells?
We've got a file on her. She's supposedly a distant relation of Richard Wagner's, although I don't believe that connection has ever been adequately established. Nonetheless, as a child, she was constantly pressured by her parents to become an opera singer, presumably in order to continue the family legacy. The only problem was that she was completely tone-deaf. The combination of her parents' unyielding devotion and the inevitable series of rejections she encountered once she began to audition seems to have warped her mind in unhealthy ways. As a young woman, she had several run-ins with the West German authorities, initially involving complaints about her impromptu public concerts, but eventually blossoming into allegations of smuggling, extortion, money laundering, and even murder. It's entirely possible she's fallen in with harm.
Find out what you can.
Very good, sir.
Be careful, Archer.
I'll be fine.
Welcome to Advanced Field Tactics. We've modified your cigarette lighter. It now features a built-in miniature welder. The flame should be just hot enough to cut through padlocks that can't be picked or shot off. Look for locks with dials instead of keyholes. Try welding these locks off. We've developed a new lipstick explosive for you. This one has a 3-second timer, which will allow you to bank it around corners or seek cover before it detonates.
I'm so bloody bored. I never have any fun. Me neither.
Meet.
This looks like the place.
Hey, Brady. I want you to meet somebody. This is Keith Miner. He's the new hire I was telling you about.
Nice to meet you, Keith.
This is an impressive operation you guys got going here.
Well, I hear you used to work over at Misery. Were you involved in that giant laser incident?
You heard about that?
Heck yeah. We had a betting pool. I was so sure you guys were gonna vaporize the Empire State Building.
Oops. I guess I owe you some money then.
What happened anyway?
We hired some non-union technicians to put in the cooling system.
No kidding. What a nightmare.
Tell me about it. It's amazing. The whole secret base didn't blow up.
It pays to hire professionals. Anyway, welcome aboard, Keith. Good to have you on the team.
I appreciate it. I got a good feeling about this organization.
Thank you.
Can you shut off this steam?
Not without a valve handle.
Where is the valve handle? Why isn't it here?
Mueller took it.
Why?
As a joke.
Where did he put it?
I don't know.
Where is he?
I don't know.
It's about damn time. I said 1 hour, not at your convenience.
Things got complicated. Your friend was killed. The one I was supposed to meet behind the club.
What? Damn it! Poor bastard.
It was a trap.
Well, I hope you don't mind walking into another one. Looks like someone's expecting us. There's bad guys all over the place.
I met a few on the way here. They were very unfriendly.
Well, don't worry, I've got a plan. We just need a diversion.
Easier said than done.
I'm a professional, sister. I took the liberty of planting some time bombs. That ought to get their attention. After what happened at the club, I didn't want to take any chances.
Excellent. When do the fireworks begin?
Well, there's just one problem. When you didn't show up after an hour, I got nervous and deactivated the timers. We'll have to reset them. There are four in that warehouse over there. If you can take care of those, I'll tend to the others.
How will I find them?
I stuck them to fuel barrels. You just have to keep your eyes open. Once you find them, set them to go off at 11:15. That'll give us half an hour. Meet me back here when you're done. And don't be late this time.
I'll do my best.
Thank you.
Got a cigarette? Huh? Cigarette? Nah, I'm trying to quit. No, do you have one? Oh, no, sorry. Why are you trying to quit? I don't know. Makes me feel yucky. Kathy doesn't smoke, does she? No, why? No, nothing. Just seems ironic, is all. What are you trying to say? Forget it.
No, don't say it. Ah! Yes, I'm afraid we're going to need lots of...
Oh. Moon heads down.
Come out of there! I don't care if you do call it. Come out for bleeding sake. Oh dear.
Ah!
going on out there?
I don't know.
Maybe you aren't getting enough sleep.
I guess that's it.
Come, you're homesick or something? Lying awake thinking about your high school sweetheart writing her love letters?
I don't know. Maybe it's just a stress.
Again, I'll slit your throat and feed you to the sharks.
Thank you.
Grab a seat. It's almost showtime.
I hope this works.
It'll work. Damn, looks like they're leaving some guards behind. Well, I guess it's better than dealing with all of them. Wish me luck.
Wish you luck?
What, you thought I was gonna let you handle this? It's way too dangerous.
Is that so?
Absolutely.
Why? Because I'm a woman? What did I tell you about patronizing me?
Just drop the Joan of Arc routine, okay? I've got a lot more field experience than you do.
I've read your file. Subtlety isn't really your specialty, is it?
I can be subtle.
Then explain that shirt.
What's wrong with it?
Look, I've spent most of my life getting into places I'm not supposed to be. Anyway, if I do get into trouble, I'll be needing a knight in shining armor to come to my rescue, won't I?
Well, when you put it that way.
Good, then I'm off.
Wait, how are you planning to get aboard? You can't just waltz up the gangplank.
I'll figure something out.
You really don't like this shirt?
Ciao.
Thank you. Hey, I just got word that there was some...
like a milkmaid.
You're kidding?
No, I'm not kidding. What's her name? Inge Wagner. How did you know? She came aboard an hour ago. Oh, didn't you read the memo in the galley? You never read those.
Thank you.
I not just kill her?
Don't tell me my business, laddie.
Yes, sir. But I don't see why you don't just kill her.
You won't be seeing anything if you don't do as I say right now.
Yes, sir.
Armstrong! Where are you? I demand an explanation.
Explanation for what?
Heinrich tells me the girl is still alive. Perhaps you did not understand my orders.
Your orders? Ha! You don't give me orders.
She was to be liquidated. Why did you spare her?
I'll not slay a countryman without a fair fight. The girl's just doing her job.
She's a threat to our operation. I'm sure the director would agree with me.
Then you kill her.
Coward.
Fatty.
Drunk.
Fatty.
You disgust me. What was that?
That's an explosion.
Find out what's going on.
Jawohl, Frau Wagner.
Abandon ship! Abandon ship!
Did he say ship or sheep?
Ship, I think. Why?
No reason.
What about the cargo?
You're welcome to fetch it, fatty. As for me, I'm getting off this boat before she sinks.
But the operation?
We can replace the cargo, but I'm one of a kind, if you take my meaning.
The director will not be pleased.
Then stay here and show your devotion. I'll nail up a commemorative plaque for you in the ladies' room of that wretched nightclub of yours.
I can't help it if my beautiful cabaret is infested with beatniks. I've tried to get rid of them, but they're like roaches.
Probably because they think you sing like that on purpose. Experimental jazz or some such shite.
Cretin.
Enough of this jabbering. You're out of my way. Your hideous mass is blocking the bulkhead.
The bulkhead's blocked. What do we do?
Don't panic. Let's go through the engine room.
about the abyss!
Damn it!
Damn it! Let's get the hell out of here!